My wife Peggy and I started coming to First Covenant back in 2013. Growing up was difficult for me. I didn't have the best childhood. My mother and my father divorced when I was just a young baby. So my mom raised my brother and I for the first 10 years of our lives. And that was tough, you know, not having a father figure around. And my mom was pretty strict, and I had problems measuring up to her standards a lot. So growing up was kind of hit and miss for me. We would go to church, you know, maybe 2 weeks in a row, and then it might be 3 months before we go again. So it was really hard to keep that momentum up and have a strong faith center. So just real inconsistent nurturing of faith. My mom remarried when I was 10. It was about that time that my mom's health really started deteriorating, both physically and mentally. It ended up where I was really looking after my brother and sister more than, you know, an older brother probably should. And my mom was addicted to prescription drugs, and she was an alcoholic. That was kind of the main focus of her world, was making sure that she had those things. And she was in and out of mental institutions for a good 5 years or so, and things just kept deteriorating. She'd be gone, checked into mental hospital for months at a time, and finally when I was 15, she committed suicide. And of course that's a devastating blow to the family, and you know, even as bad as things were, you know, that made things much worse and really broke the family, and kind of started my life over again. And I was fortunate enough to meet Peggy in the Army, and we married when I was 19. We've been married for over 20 years now. I felt like I didn't really have like a close family of my own. I'd come home with Peggy from the Army, and we'd visit with her family, and this real tight-knit family, and I really wanted that. Throughout most of my early adulthood, I struggled with that. I began to struggle with depression. I should have been happy, but for some reason I felt hopeless. Things were, you know, getting bad enough. I really felt kind of worthless, and I didn't understand what was going on. I just felt a big hole in my life, and, you know, really started searching at that point. When we started having children back in 2011, when Madison was born, it kind of hit a peak for me, and I really started to panic because I didn't know how to parent. I didn't have a role model growing up to really model that for me, to know, you know, how do I parent successfully. So it was at that point that Peggy and I were fortunate enough to get an invitation to come to First Covenant, and we did. We've been coming ever since, and we committed ourselves to Christ, and were baptized. Through that transition, I no longer had that feeling of sadness about not having a close-knit family, because I knew I was part of God's family. I felt valued, and my priorities started shifting. I became part of the Ironman ministry group and helped started serving others. And I realized at one point, you know, after I'd given myself back to God and really started to identify problem areas in my life and reevaluate what was important to me, I realized that I had this perfect model of what a father is all along. And it just hit me one day. And once I made that connection, I was no longer afraid of parenting. It made me a better husband. It made me a better person. God really used my hurt from my childhood to better the kingdom. I never would have thought that I'd end up in children's ministries, but somehow I found myself teaching on Wednesday nights and on Sunday mornings to fifth and sixth graders. And you know, I'm just really able to use my background to help children identify needs that they have. And I just feel really passionate about making sure that I can do what I'm able to make sure they don't go through some of the same issues that I did growing up. You know, if you had asked me 10 years ago where I would be, wouldn't be mentoring kids. But that was God's path for me. It just feels natural. And I just love being able to identify with some of the problems that the kids are going through. And I think I'm able to help them out because I've gone through so many difficult situations myself. It's kind of where I'm at. And that's my faith story.